Hey everybody, how you doing out there? It's yours truly. I just want to talk about a whole bunch of things. I'm going to make these videos from now on, made for kids videos. I'm going to make for kid videos in here, and that's going to be my videos. It's going to be made for kids, so if you understand that, this video is for you. I mean that literally. I want to talk about I, Justine. You might have heard about her. She has a book, a memoir. And, she was famous on YouTube. She's I, Justine, and she does a lot of videos out there, and I want to give her kudos where kudos is due. She's a famous YouTuber. I don't get to see her videos very often like I used to, and when I do, it turns out great. Turns out wonderful. Oh, by the way, folks, I want to spread the word, spread the information out there, and give you the intel. That's right, the intel. I want to give you the inside intel. You know the guys from the Duke Boys, the Dukes of Hazzard? One of those Duke Boys has a YouTube channel. John Snyder, you might have heard about him. He was one of those Duke Boys in that TV show, the Dukes of Hazzard. This is going back to the way of the early 80s show. Well, John Snyder, you may have seen him in those TV shows. He is definitely on YouTube. I kid you not, folks. This is the guy that you grew up with, the Dukes of Hazzard. He now has a YouTube channel. As a kid growing up on Dukes of Hazzard and Knight Rider, you get David Hasselhoff, you get the Duke Boys. What more do you want? You know, as a kid growing up, you just love these shows that they put out. The craziness that goes on. The Dukes of Hazzard was a kid's favorite in the early 70s and 80s. If you're a 70s baby, early 80s, people were watching Dukes of Hazzard to the Knight Riders. There was A-Team. Remember that show, The A-Team? Oh my God, you have Mr. T, the guy, big bulk Mr. T. Oh, you had that guy. You had Knight Rider, who was David Hasselhoff. I don't know if he's still around. If he's still around, give me a plug. You know what I'm saying? I'm just trying to say it like a YouTuber here. Hit that like button or hit that share button. And don't forget to subscribe to my channel. This is kid-driven content. Kids-driven content. If you're a kid out there at a certain age, like if you're 5 years old, I don't know what age you're at, but if you're 5 years old, 10 years old, 15 years old, of adult, if you're past the 20 years old age and you're an adult, where's the age limit? When you turn 18, you're an adult. When you turn that 18 age, you're an adult at that point. You don't want your mommy and daddy to ask you about things and stuff. So you turn to be an adult and you do adult things beyond the 18 age. You know, you're not a 16, sweet 16. You're not, when you turn 18, you're an adult and you do adult things out there that you love to do. So I'm going to direct my content out there with all the kids around the world. We're all talking about kids. This whole nation, this whole United States and Canada talk about kids at a certain age. This next generation, I'm always talking about the next generation of kids. I always tell them, stay young. Don't be 70 or 80 or 90 years old. It's when you're really old and you don't do very much. When you're really young, and I miss my young years, I really do. I'm really missing those years. So I always tell kids out there, just stay young. Just stay very much young in your life. Because you don't get those beautiful moments when you're really young, when you're at 5 years old, 10 years old, 15 years old. You really don't get those moments anymore. It's like if you turn like 60 years old, you kind of relive it. That's the only part, that the drawback you get. So always do, I always tell people, do lots of things out there. Keep the memories alive. Keep things what you do out there. And hope you make a point out there to make what videos should be like today. And I want to put out the content I want to put out. I want to set the bar really high, and this is a kid-driven content. Kids that are out there, children at age between 5 and 10, 15, and 18, 20 years old, 26 years old. If you're 26 years old, great, wonderful. You're past the adult age, because originally 18 is the paddle, the age that everybody's past, that age, 18 age. 18 years old, you don't need mommy and daddy anymore to buy your stuff. You can buy your own stuff. Anyway, I want to say to this, so this content is going to be driven with kids only out there. It's going to be kid-driven content. So that's what I'm going to adhere to, kid-driven content out there on YouTube. That's right. It's not going to be adult-driven content. It's going to be the kid-driven content out there. So I'm going to gear it to every age bracket. Every age bracket's out there. Really, yeah. And so no adult, no kid should be squeamish about my content. If they're an adult, that's great. They can see my footage. It's going to be family content-driven. So it's going to be very much family content, and they're pushed out there to the narrative. I'm going to push the narrative for kids and adults, so it's all ages content. So it's going to be all ages content here, starting this week. So I'm going to try and do that for a little while, and we'll see how it goes. And if I like it, I'll stay doing this. If I don't like it, I'll always change. Change my ways, change my whole perspective. And, sorry I'm laughing. I'm thinking about a whole bunch of videos I saw today. I'm not going to mention them here. It's just the way of the world is today. Folks, I'm not talking about people who have jobs or lost jobs, who are trying to get jobs out there. The Joe Bidens of the world, you got your Joe Bidens of the world, the President of the United States, he's trying to get the economy up and running. It's a Build Back Better thing. You may have heard about that many times. Joe Biden has mentioned that in press conferences, Build Back Better mentality. And he's just telling people, wear a mask, get vaccinated. And you probably heard of the previous videos I put up there. About Joe Biden was really, really, I forget the word now, but he was really over exonerating himself with that. But now I think the world's going to tank if Joe Biden would be careful about the economy, because it's going to tank. It's going to tank. It's going to go down the toilet. Economy is not going to be back where it should be. We need to get the ball rolling. We need to get the economy up and running again. Not this low wages, you know, $15 minimum wage that, Senator Bernie Sanders is always saying. He had the crowd really cheer for him for that one. $15 an hour of minimum wage, that's a lot of money to you and I. I mean, that was definitely great for the young people out there who are working out there. $15 an hour, if I heard it right, for Senator Bernie Sanders. I try not to laugh about this. I always remember him saying that. So he's out there on a podium telling the young people out there about this $15 an hour minimum wage. It's a good idea. It's a good idea, folks. It very is a good idea to have the economy up and running again. I think Bernie Sanders was onto something there. Really, he was. And I may not have it right or wrong, but that was certainly a good idea when he was rallying around, you know, his base, his, you know, his crowds. So I think people appreciated that when Bernie Sanders stayed to the crowd. $15 an hour wage, and it really stick for those young people out there. And so this is job losses, and people don't have jobs. Just yesterday, people were talking about these are folks who are retired. These are not like young kids. These are not kids of 18, 10 to 15. They're not ready to be retired. They're not. They're at the young age. They're not ready to retire from lengthy job stuff out there. Like I said, folks, these are the old folks. Old folks, they want to retire that soon to stay in age. It's a retirement. It sends these people to retirements. That's kind of crazy, you know. That's really crazy. I'm just saying to myself, where's the pension? Where's the, you know, for old age pension stuff? So that's crazy. This is from the United States. There's a lot of people going basically, old age. They're retiring from life, and it's a good way of saying it. But we need to get the economy up and running again. You know, I'm kind of with Joe Biden. We need to get the economy back and running. Bridge fixes, supposed to be fixes. We need all these things that Joe Biden has really hinted on. What $1 trillion the stimulus package that they're going to have out there. I think it's a good idea. They were supposed to have it today. I don't know the updates on that. You guys will have to tell me out there. But this $1 trillion stimulus package bill to get the economy up and running. That's trillion. That's not billions. That's trillion. So you can fathom that's ones with a lot of zeros. A big amount for $1 trillion. So he's trying to get the economy up and running again. Have jobs out there, wanted signs. There's probably going to be wanted signs very soon, very soon. I want to tell the American people this. In the next few months or so, people are going to put wanted signs out there for jobs out there. This is for job seekers. These are definitely job seekers out there. I just heard yesterday people are just putting out the resumes, getting these jobs soon. I would say in the next year or so, people are going to look for jobs. These are going to be job seekers out there and full force. And they're going to be out there full force with the job seeking jobs out there. And that's going to be in the next few months. I said it earlier tonight. I think people are going to go look for jobs, and it's not going to be any quietness on the roads. It's going to be a lot of people looking for jobs these days. The next few months, at least for 3 years, at least beyond the 3 years. Because you don't want the economy to tank. You don't want that. You don't want the banks to go bankrupt. You don't want the economy to go tanking. It's going to be not a good idea. So hear what I have to say, folks out there, the American people. We don't want the economy to tank. We don't want to go into a sort of situation where there's no money in banks. There's no money in the economy. We don't want to go down to zero and find out we have no more money for the cities. No more money for the cities. I mean, it's like going broke. It's like going broke. It's like dire straits. It's like it's like really, really at that point, folks. So Joe Biden is trying to, he's the commander-in-chief, as everybody would say. He's commander-in-chief. He's the president of the United States. We like him or not, he's still the president of the United States, folks. And you're going to have to like his policy. You don't have to like his policy. Remember that. And I just sometimes I don't agree with Joe Biden what he's been saying lately. At one time I just got fed up about all his masking, all his vaccines. I just got up to here with that nonsense. So I was just fed up. You know, he was on and on. It's like that. It's like going through a revolving door kind of thing. I was kind of a little upset there. And, you know, I had to put my views out there about that. Even the President of the United States can make you really, really upset. I think he does it for the greater good. He means well. You know, it's like your dad. He means well. He doesn't, you know, he's trying to tell everybody to go get vaccinated. I don't tell you people to do that. These are leaders around the world that tell you that. For me, I will never tell you that if you go get your vaccines or wear your mask. And I will never do that. I'll never, ever, ever, ever do that, folks. It's just, it was a wild ride this week. A lot of news came out this week, the whole entire week. We had Andrew Cuomo. My thoughts on it. I made myself very clear on that. What I said to that. And if I were Andrew Cuomo, I would just let it, it's like everything in life. Everything should pass. Just let it be. Let it simmer a bit. You know, it's like having a pot on a stove. Let it simmer a bit, you know. I think if nobody mentions it, nobody talks about it, it's going to go away like a donut board. You know, it's going to be scrubbed under the rug, not mentioned for a long, long time. And, yeah, so if a lot of people don't mention it, then it's not an issue. It's not a non-issue, they would say. I think it's like everything in the world. It's like events in the world, you know. It shall pass. We've gone to the event. We saw it. We came. We conquered it. We did all those things. We saw the band members. I think they were great or awesome. And, yeah, we move on. We all move on to the next venue. It's another event, another concert to go see. Remember, we can't please everybody. Just please everybody. So, folks, hear what I've got to say. So, Andrew Cuomo, Governor Andrew Cuomo, just everything shall pass in life. In life, everything shall pass. If people don't bring it up, it's going to be like dead on arrival. It's kind of like that. Or, better yet, this is another thing I would say, or just don't try and mention it anymore. Because if you keep mentioning it, it's like giving oxygen to the situation. You know, it's like that, in a way. So, I think everybody got caught up on this. Even Governor Andrew Cuomo got caught up on it, which was really weird. Even Justin Trudeau, he was talking about his incident, about his black-faced incident, and he was right on the ball in that. It didn't fade him out. It didn't linger, you know, for a while. He just went out there and said it, and said he apologized, and it didn't linger, didn't have the people talk about it immensely. So he just did what he had to do. He had to tell everybody, this is a non-issue, it'll go away. He apologized, he moved on. We all move on. It's like the old saying goes, we all move on. And, yeah, so folks, this week was a bit of nonsense, and all these news stories that are going on these days. It's going to be a wild ride for this year. We're already gone through halfway through the year already. We've gone through 2021 year, and we're going to celebrate the new year, the next year, very shortly, in the next few months. And, with that, hope you guys are hit that like button and share the videos. And if you want to subscribe to my channel, you are welcome to. And it's an option for you guys out there. And if you want to hear my videos, you can. But I want to make it a kid-friendly video out there. My content's going to be kid-friendly content, if you know what I mean. So I'm going to put out the kid-friendly content out there so nobody gets squeamish. And I won't put like a viewer discretion advice thing, or I won't put, so I don't know that. This is like a kid, family-oriented content for you viewers out there and the listeners out there. So I'll keep doing that until the cows come home, or until I'm blue in the face. So folks, just bear this in mind. People are doing the best they can out there. You get the Governor of Florida, he kind of told Joe Biden a thing or two. he came left field on what he said. So anyway, it's been silly as of late in the news and all these leaders around the world, and so far it's like stirring the pot of news stories around the world. You know, it's all doing the narrative. You know, people got to go to A to B. It's like a destination thing. So, it's just a little bit faster, a little bit hang on tight kind of thing. We're all going to be in this world together. We're going to get through this like 9/11, you know. Oh, speaking of 9/11, this coming September, we got a few weeks now. This September, we'll have a special edition of 9/11. It's close to the anniversary coming up very shortly, in about a month or so. Why I mention, you say? Because it's the anniversary. I had no family members whatsoever at those two buildings that came down. Thank God for that. Nobody from my family was working there. So that's, you know, knock on wood. Yeah, we're coming up to the 20th anniversary. People people might have forgotten about this. We're coming up to the anniversary, the 20th anniversary of this 9/11 thing. And this is from the American side of thing. They haven't mentioned it quite so much as years go by. But yes, it's coming up to 20th anniversary. I'll make a special edition about that one coming up very shortly, in about a month or so. So there'll be a special edition to that, and what my thoughts are, and we're going to talk about it in length. And we might, if time permits, you know, we'll do a thoughtful thinking and what 20 years and what we come to conclusions to it. At the time, people were swirling this pot, you know, the conspiracy pot, and saying, okay, it's an inside job. 9/11 was an inside job. We got that. People thought, okay, maybe it was the government that did this. No, it was somebody who hijacked the planes. Yep, maybe so. Was it, so people had many stories about 9/11. Now I want to talk about the survivors of 9/11. These are true 100% survivors of 9/11 from those buildings or from the street areas. I will talk about that in length. These are real survivors. These are not fake survivors. These are real survivors. They're going to have real stories. It's like, you know, just we're going to talk about the whole enchilada. So real stories about people who survived 9/11, who lived to talk about 20 years later. And so I'm going to have my thoughts. The real survivors that survived 9/11 from those two buildings and the street levels areas from those two buildings. The street levels. It was a lot happening that time frame. So there was people from the street areas. There was people inside the buildings. Remember, these are big buildings. In big buildings, they would have to use stairs or elevators. Usually elevators that get them down really fast. But stairs, it takes forever. It takes very much ever. If you got a big tall building, it takes forever to go all the way down a flight of stairs. That's forever. That is truly forever. That's why they try and put elevators in big tall buildings in New York City. Because it's a lot faster going upward and downward. That's why they make elevators for. So they get down to the ground much faster, much easier. And because the many floors they add, the harder that they go all the way down to the bottom of first floor. And that's what everybody should worry about. But we're going to talk about in a special edition. You know, like CDs would have special editions. We're going to make it a special edition TV show talking about 9/11 20 years later. And I'm going to put a title on there. And we want to talk about the survivors. These are real survivors, not the fake ones. And we'll talk about the people that were around that area, around the New York area, around that time frame, and just people who were in those buildings who were survivors, not ones who passed on. We might talk about the people that passed on. Remember, it's the 20th anniversary. We're going to talk about the special edition to that coming up this next month, and we'll talk close to that date. Close to that date, folks. So yeah, be well aware of that, and we'll make it a special edition. We'll make it a special podcast for that, and we'll talk about everything, the people that survived that, people who perished in that, people who may God runs a soul from 9/11, and just, you know, and the people who were around that little areas, and yeah, planes didn't hit those buildings. It hit the Pentagon, it hit the Twin Towers, it hit another plane that, these are people who are going to hijack the plane. You would never hear this very often. But yeah, these are bad people. They hijack the plane, they overtake the plane. And you don't hear it very often, but this happened in American soil, folks. So anyway, hope you enjoyed this podcast. I hope you appreciate what I have to say, and before September 11th, before the actual date, we're going to celebrate 20 years later, and how people are 20 years later, We're going to talk about the real survivors. We're going to talk about the people that were there in that city core area. And we'll do a special edition. I'll make it a special edition in the title. And are we ever better off than we did 20 years ago? And what we had in place to, you know, everybody was a heightened awareness after 9/11. This was 5 years out. This was 5 years after 9/11 that everybody was in high alert. That was the 9/11. So 5 years after 9/11, everybody was in high awareness. By that time, everybody was looking around their shoulder just in case, you know. So it was a strange time for a lot of people, a lot of Americans, a lot of Canadians. It was a strange time. And 20 years later, have we learned something from 9/11? And have we been a better people from 9/11? So I'm going to put this out as a great video. Appreciate it. Hope you appreciate this too, folks. Anyway, ciao for now. See you on the next podcast. Till then.